religion teaches you about Jesus. And the Quran teaches you many times about Jesus. You believe Jesus is a prophet, but you deny Jesus. You don't obey Jesus. The prophet to believe, you have to obey, you have to follow. This is the word of God. And here, Jesus, he teaches you, be a peacemaker, be merciful, forgive others. That is the word of God. God will not teach you to kill others. God can live himself without you. But God teaches you to love others, forgive others, be a peacemaker, be merciful. This is what Jesus, he teaches from this Bible.
And the prophet here,
you don't believe in Jesus. If you believe Jesus, follow him, obey him. The Quran says, obey the gospel of Jesus. You don't believe. When you believe in the Quran, you take his Bible and obey the gospel of Jesus. And the Quran says that your God is merciful, is grateful. And your Quran says that God is merciful, is grateful, is not a criminal. And my Bible says that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Jesus Christ was sent by God in this world to save you from hell. No matter how many you have, all that matters for you to obey Jesus. To be a Muslim, it means to be submitted to the will of God. The will of God for you today is to repent. The will of God for you today is to believe in Jesus. If you believe Jesus, you follow Jesus, you obey Jesus. You don't believe Jesus, you lie. If you believe Jesus, you obey Jesus. Good for you. He come back for me, for those who are waiting for him. Jesus Christ will come back for the church, for those who are waiting for him. And the rest of you will be judged by Jesus. Jesus will judge the world. John, we read the book of John, chapter 14, verse 8. When the Thomas asked Jesus a question, he said, show us who is the Father. Show us who is God. And Jesus says, you see me, see the Father. And Jesus says also in John chapter 10, he says, I and my Father are one. I and my Father are one. So Jesus is the image of God. Jesus is the presence of God in the earth. We believe as God because of his resurrection. There's no prophet to resurrect, but Jesus is resurrected. And that's why we believe Jesus as God.
So
Jesus Christ, he proved through his word to be God. Even of his resurrection.
When is there resurrection?
The Bible says,
eternal.
If we love one another, God is in us. If you don't love others, the devil is in you. The Bible says that we are creation of God. God created man and woman in His image.
Including Jesus.
Today, the church is the image of God. Because the church are the people who are born again with the love of God, with the Spirit of God.
How do you born again?
How? When you repent of your sin and you go to be baptized in the water
to
the name of Jesus, you are born again. When you confess your sin and you repent and you ask for forgiveness,
ask
Jesus to come into your life,
you will be born again.
You will be born again.
Jesus himself, he asked God. You know that? Jesus himself, he asked God. So why I don't ask God directly?
Jesus came.
He himself asked
Jesus
God,
yeah? Came to teach you how to pray, how to worship the Father.
Jesus came
to be an example for you. He came to be an example to follow.
So he's not good. He's an example and messenger
Jesus
and delivery man.
Knows everybody. He follow me. That's what Jesus said.
To go where?
Follow me.
To go where?
When you follow Jesus,
to go where?
You obey Jesus. Jesus declared, be a peacemaker, be merciful. What does it mean for you to be merciful?
Jesus is a messenger
others.
From God.
Forgive
and he's a Jewish
others.
Man, he born from Virgin Mary.
What does it mean?
He's a delivery you man from the creator.
A peacemaker. Can I ask you?
He didn't die.
What does it mean
you?
For you to be a peacemaker? A peacemaker does not kill, does not fight.
He's
a peacemaker humble himself.
I go to Thailand to help when I don't kill nobody.
King David, okay. King David, he have enemies. He prayed, he said, Lord, you fight.
He prayed to God. That means he's not God. You don't think about it?
He was worshiping God.
Is this God required to turn to another God?
One day, seven times, one day, King David, he worshiped God. He prayed to God.
He prayed to God. Does that mean he's not God?
Do you know what happened? Do you know what happened?
Listen,
King David,
he prayed to God.
He discovered himself
he to God.
Of sin.
He said, "Me, he's not God. We don't believe God to pray to
him. We're going to pray of sin."
That's crazy, man. Can you pray for him? Can you pray for that man?
7 days.
He's sick.
Seven times a day. Seven times a day.
The dog is
seven days.
Ah, is that your dog?
I should call
yourself a Christian, man.
I should call
that. 7 times a day, 7 days a week, King David, he prayed, worshiped God 7 times. At the end, King David discovered himself as a sinner. He prayed to God for forgiveness. How many times do you pray to God a day? Do you discover yourself as a sinful man? You don't. Because when you pray, you do exercise. You don't pray. Your prayer is only exercise. When you pray to God, you need to cry to God. You cry to God for mercy. Ask God to forgive your sins. That's why Jesus came. Preach repentance. That's why every prophet came to preach repentance. A prophet who teach you to kill, that's not a prophet, that's the devil himself.
What about self-defense if someone was to attack?
Moses, a prophet, when the people sin against God, Moses, he prayed for them. 40 days, 40 nights, he fast and he prayed for them. Father, forgive them. Jesus Christ came to pray for you in the cross. Father, forgive them. Today is your day to receive forgiveness. Today is your day to receive salvation.
You said Moses prayed to God, right? But Moses killed a man himself. Moses was his sin. And you said that Jesus prayed to God.
You don't understand.
Yourself.
You don't understand.
And you,
you don't
that
understand
we
that God is
we pray
merciful.
You said that we pray as exercise. Excuse me. We
you don't understand.
We pray for our sins. We
Moses.
Pray for God to forgive
you
us.
Don't understand. God is merciful.
Yes, God. Not Jesus.
Apostle
God
Paul, Apostle Paul, he persecuted the church, the Christians, and Jesus spoke to Paul in heaven, why you are persecuting me? Paul received forgiveness, he received mercy, now he's a disciple of Jesus. God is merciful.
Yes,
God will forgive you as you repent.
Yes, God, not Jesus.
Today you receive forgiveness. I don't know how many people you beat. I don't know how many people you killed.
I don't know how many people you beat.
I don't know. God knows. God knows how many people you beat. God knows how many people you are fighting with. But God also is waiting for you to repent.
Yes, indeed.
I repent.
Yes, I repent.
I ask forgiveness.
I pray 5 times a day.
I accept Jesus in my life.
I accept Jesus.
God save my life.
I accept Jesus as
no more drugs, no more alcohol. Finished. I have new life. Jesus.
As a prophet.
When you repent of your sin.
I repent for my
when
sin.
You ask the Lord to forgive you.
I ask the Lord for forgiveness.
You don't.
Yes, I do.
How would you know if I ask the Lord for forgiveness? When Jesus,
I pray 5 times a day and I say astaghfirullah, which means I repent for my sin.
You know what Jesus had done? Jesus came to forgive people. He says, your sins are forgiven today. Only God can forgive, right? But Jesus came and he says, your sins are forgiven. When Jesus forgives, he heals you. Yes. Because Jesus says, I and my Father are one. Jesus, God, are one. So when God forgives, at the same time God will challenge you. You'll never be the same. When you smoke, do you smoke? Do you smoke? You see people around you smoking? Yes. Your body, the temple of God. Why people smoke? Because they don't honor God. You see?
Yes, that's true.
So you need to repent before God.
Yes, we repent to Allah.
You need to honor God.
We repent to Allah.
How do you receive forgiveness?
You ask Allah for forgiveness.
You receive forgiveness
by asking Allah.
When you are changed.
Yes.
When you are healed.
Yes.
When God will forgive you,
will forgive you
will never be the same.
Yes.
God, if you tell me now,
you could do the same
if thing. You tell me that you pray now, you ask Allah for forgiveness, and tomorrow you're still the same.
You
live sinful life every day.
But Allah is merciful. His mercy is out to everyone. He will forgive you. You can repeat the same sin.
Allah is merciful.
Yes.
What about you? Are you merciful?
Yes.
No, you are not.
Yes. How would you know? Excuse
you me? Are not.
So you're telling me those people are praying and you they are asking for forgiveness.
You're born in sin. You have anger in your heart, in your mind. Your thoughts are evil. You never think about how can I love someone today? What good can I do to somebody? You need the love of God in your heart.
How are you saying?
You need the love of God to be able to love others.
I pray, I do charity, I fast, I go to pilgrimage. What else do you do? I go to pilgrimage. What is the result? Can you prove to God that you deserve
to go to his glory?
No, you have to be humble.
Can you prove to God you deserve to go in his glory?
But it's God who forgives you.
You are a dust. We all are a dust. We don't deserve to go to there, to heaven.
Yes,
we don't deserve. We are evil. We are sinners. That's why Jesus came. To forgive, to heal, to set you free. You are people who said, when you hate someone, when you want to fight someone, that's the devil in you. So you need Jesus. You need the power of God to cast out all demons from you. You need the love of God, because only the love of God can humble you. You know, when you pray to God, you don't do exercise.
Yes.
And you put your head in the floor for 2 minutes.
How you say
and that's
that
it. When you pray to God, you need to cry unto Him.
Yes.
To confess your sin. Ask for forgiveness.
Can I tell you something? When we pray, especially when we're fasting from Ramadan, and after we pray our last prayer, we pray for our win. And that when people pray to God, when you're crying, when you're hungry,
do you believe that you are the only one who pray who fast? No? Do you believe you are the only one? When I pray, God open the heaven for me.
How are you so sure?
Tell me what God has done to you. What God has done to you when you pray? Nothing.
What?
When I pray, the Lord God opened heaven for me.
How do you know that?
When I pray, I receive my healing.
Wait, one second. You say that we do not pray.
I was addicted to drugs. I smoked crack, cocaine, weed, marijuana, everything. Cigarette. I was addicted. When I pray, I said, Jesus, only you can set me free.
Would you?
God can only
say,
not Jesus.
You don't understand. God sent Jesus in His word.
As a prophet.
You believe as a prophet? God bless you.
Okay.
I believe as a son of God. You believe as a prophet? God bless you.
And He has been your witness.
If I believe as a son of God,
you disagree with me.
You believe Jesus as a prophet, I agree with you.
I agree.
I am nothing against you. If I believe Jesus as a son of God, that means I have more experience.
Can I ask you something? There is video footage on my phone that you just said Jesus is God. I'm just saying that Jesus is God, but you're also saying right now that Jesus is the Son of God. You are contradicting yourself.
Yes, Jesus came.
Jesus prayed to God.
Jesus came. Jesus came in the end, okay? Now, people believe Jesus as a prophet, okay? Jesus asked a question to His disciples. What these people think about me? Who they think I am? The disciples, they tell, well, some of them, they are saying you are a Jeremiah, you are Elijah, the prophet. Who do you think I am? And Peter, he said, you are the Son of the living God. God bless you. My Father in heaven discovered you about me. You see, Jesus revealed Himself as the Son of God, not to everybody, only to the chosen ones. Jesus Christ revealed to me as the Son of God because He chose me for His glory. So you believe Him as a prophet, God bless you.
You said that.
If you believe Jesus as a prophet, obey Jesus. Do what He says. Yes, I am.
I only chose you, not us, no one else here, only you.
I don't know, God knows. If you are the chosen one, Jesus will reveal Himself to you, He will visit you, He will call you. Yes, He visited me. He came to my home.
Your house?
Yes.
Oh my God.
He visited me.
Time to come here next week.
Let me tell you something. For you to see Jesus, you need to cry a lot. For you to see Jesus, you need to wait upon Him. You need to pray to Him. You need to read the Bible. You need to live righteous life. For you to see Jesus, your mind has to be in God. How can you see Jesus if your mind is not in God?
You see, you're arguing. You've got reading treaty.
Yeah, I get that.
What proves you that you're a Christian? When you say you're a Christian, when you say you're a Christian, what proves you to believe? What reason gives me to believe you're a Christian? I don't believe you. I don't believe you. You see, a Christian is the one who believes Jesus.
And she does.
You don't. The Bible says.